63%. Nearly 2 in 3 Americans are living paycheck to paycheck. And 4 in 10 households would struggle to pay even a $400 emergency expense, with the extra bill sending them further into debt. The fallout from the pandemic is affecting everyone, even those of us right here in the Bowtie Nation.
So then when, you know, you're running out of money sooner than before and you start relying on credit cards.
We were really getting strapped for cash to make ends meet. When you're having to use a credit card to get groceries just to make ends meet.
If you're tired and broke or just tired of being broke, then remember this video because it will be the one that changes your life. With this video, I'm starting a series to show you a millionaire strategy using side hustles, passive income, and investing. And for the first time ever, highlighting a success story from you right there in the community. Throughout this video, I'll show you how to make money and back it up with proof from two of you out there in the Bowtie Nation.
You've taken the step
not
to be scared to get out there and try it. And now that we have and we've seen how well it does work, you know, there's not really any going back after that. There's no backtracking after that. I mean, it's too much. It's too empowering. It's just too, I don't know.
It's almost addicting in a good way.
In this video, I'll give you a complete roadmap to that millionaire payday and how to put yourself on that path to financial freedom. We'll start by creating the goals and the mindset you need and then reveal the truth to how the rich become wealthy. Then I'll share 6 millionaire habits and action steps you can use to start right now. Stick around because towards the end of the video, I'll show you a simple 3-step checklist to get started fast. Later in the video, I'll introduce you to Brian and Crystal, how buying a truck they couldn't afford almost drove them into bankruptcy, and how they've been able to turn that around, creating wealth through passive income, side hustles, and investing. Don't forget to join the community and check out the playlist in the video description below. Besides the millionaire mindset and action steps I'll show you in this video, I'll take you step by step to making money throughout the series to make 2022 the year that changes your life. And the first step on your path to becoming a millionaire is actually most people's last step, asking yourself why you want to be rich. Duh, because being rich is so much better than being poor, right? Nation, they say money can't buy happiness, but money does buy jet skis, and you can't spell happiness without jet skis. H-A-P-P-I-N. The problem is that dream of jet skis and sunny beaches just isn't enough. It's not enough when the hours get long creating your passive income stream. It's not enough when the temptation to reinvest your profits gets hijacked by that new Audi commercial. The only way anyone makes it to that kind of level, to that kind of wealth and financial freedom we're talking about, is by embracing their why, by making those goals so real, they become the motivation. For example, 2 citizens of the Bowtie Nation out there, Brian and Crystal, are working hard on their plan to create that future. I recently sat down and asked them about their why, about their goals.
The goal for our side hustles are to be financially free down the road, to get out of debt, not to be rich by any means, because we don't really expect to get rich. If it happens, that's great. I mean, I'm all for it. But mainly just to pay off debt and not to have to worry about how we're going to pay the bills or do things that we would like to do.
Yeah, it helps to do things now, of course. Like if you want to go out to eat, you don't have to, you're not counting money in your head. Like, do I have enough in my account to pay for this?
So the first thing we've got to do is turn that why of becoming wealthy into goals, and then those goals into a mental picture. And your goals can be a lot of things, like retirement, college tuition for the kids, buying a home, even that dream vacation. You really want several of these, some short-term, like what you want to do with your money in the next 3 to 5 years, and then some other long-term goals like retirement. And I know that sounds like the easy part, right? But this isn't something you want to just pull out of your ass and then forget about. Really sit down and think about these. If you're married or you've got a family, sit down together and see where everyone's goals and their priorities match up, because one of the worst things that can happen is that one person is saving for a goal while everyone else is spending because they just don't share that same goal. Once you have those shared goals, imagine it. Write down a story around each one. What's it going to be like sitting on that sandy beach with that coconut filled with rum? Create that story around where is it? What are you doing every day? How about watching your kid walk across the stage at their college graduation? What's the story around that? What doors are going to be open to them and that were closed for you? And the idea here is to make each of these goals so real you can feel it. It's no longer just a dream, but a snapshot of the future. It's that mental picture that is going to drive you through everything we're going to talk about in the rest of this video and throughout the series on creating wealth. These mental pictures of your goals are going to be like your motivation, your destination, because folks, if you set out trying to create that side hustle or investing without them, it's like setting out on a road trip without a destination. The hours of work, the frustrations, they create roadblocks and you end up on the side of the road out of gas. In fact, I learned this lesson the hard way during my first analyst job. I hated that job so much and all I could think about was the goal of retiring early. I worked that full-time job, another part-time job nights, and managed my own real estate rentals. I was saving every penny but never really knew what I was saving for. I had no idea what my goal of retiring early really even meant. I just knew I didn't want to work anymore. But the problem was, without that clear picture of what that even meant, how that goal was going to motivate me to keep saving, I got burnt out every 6 months, would go on a binge shopping spree, and just set myself back to zero. But create those goals and the mental pictures first, and they can take you anywhere you want to go. Now, before I reveal those three millionaire habits, the three traits that all millionaires share, we need to understand how 99% of wealth is created. And this is something that is going to change the way you think about investing. Now, we all know the conventional wisdom for getting rich is you need to find that next hot stock, the next Tesla or GameStop to 10x your money in less than a year. The result is investors jump in and out of stocks, making all the wrong decisions and end up going nowhere. In fact, JP Morgan found the average investor earns just 2.9% a year in the two decades to 2020. At an annual return of 2.9% a year, it would take you 34 years to become a millionaire, and that's investing $1,500 a month. Now, of course, all you out there in the nation, you're above average investors, right? And you're able to get that market return of 7.5% a year. That would still take you over 23 years investing every single month to reach that $1 million. In fact, to get to that millionaire level within 10 years, you would need to invest $1,500 every month at a 36% annual return. Every single year. That is just not going to happen. It's like being able to pick the very best stock of the year for 10 years in a row, and it's not how wealth is really created. In one of the most eye-opening surveys I've ever seen, Scorpio Partnership and BNP Wealth Management surveyed over 2,500 millionaires in 17 countries, people with an average net worth of nearly $8 million. And now what they found here is going to change the way you think about creating wealth and how you become a millionaire, because look at this first column. The average millionaire has just 17% of their money in stocks. That's it, less than a fifth of their wealth invested in the stock market. In fact, the average millionaire has more money in cash and bonds than they do in stocks. But the biggest source of wealth here, more than $1 in $4 of net worth, is in their own business. That single biggest source of wealth creation is in starting that business and owning those income assets. And now before we get onto those millionaire habits, to show you this can be done without finding that next hot stock, here's the income tracking on my online business. Starting with just three blogs in 2015, applying everything I'm going to show you in this video, I was able to reach that $1 million payoff in less than 6 years. In 75 months from starting, I had collected more than $1 million. Now, I will show you how to start investing in this series, but that millionaire path has to start with creating those income assets, that side hustle or the passive income idea that's going to make you truly rich. Now that you're ready to start your journey, I want to share those three millionaire traits, three habits you'll need to apply. Now, those goals and that mental picture is going to be your motivation. These three traits, those are going to be the tools that you use. And first here is going to be a wake-up call, because you have to be ready to put in that work. Yeah, sorry folks, but if you want quick and easy, I'm sure there's some 14-year-old over on TikTok that's going to show you how to do that.
Here's a side hustle for anyone that wants to make $50,000 or more per month.
With just a phone.
Elon Musk reportedly puts in 80 to 90 hours a week and has been known to sleep on his factory floor. When I was getting started in venture capital and private wealth management, my days would consist of 7 hours creating cash flow models and analysis, followed by 3 hours of meetings and pitching clients, all to go home and put in another 3 hours studying for the chartered financial analyst exams. And the weekend, just another 2 workdays until Monday. Now, this does not mean you have to be a workaholic or that this is your life from now on, but you need to be ready to do what it takes over those first 2 years, because putting in the average work week is only going to make you average, and the average is broke. Now, the best way to do this by far is to involve your family in the side hustles and your passive income ideas. This not only is going to get everyone excited about growing the business, but helps it grow faster and can even bring you closer together as you create something as a family. even if you don't want to spend that extra 5 hours a week with your family. And honestly, sometimes I don't either. There are ways of finding more time to grow your business ideas. And first here is just to figure out where your time goes. Track everything you do for a few days and put each task into one of four blocks, depending on how important it is and how much you enjoy it. For example, I have a lot of things like editing videos, working with sponsors, and business accounting that I don't particularly enjoy, but it is important, so I either need to get someone else to do it or keep doing it myself. There's also some things that aren't very important, but I do enjoy doing them, like watching Futurama. Okay, kidding, that is important. But if I am being honest, I could probably find a little extra time by maybe only watching one episode of Simpsons and one of Futurama each day, and maybe one movie a week. The best opportunities for finding time, though, are in this lower left and the stuff that you do, but it's not really important and you don't enjoy it either. For me, it's things like scrolling through social media and answering emails. And we're not even talking about 20 or 30 hours a week here. You can start your side hustle or an income idea with as little as 5 hours a week. Hell, according to the BLS Time Use Survey, the average person spends nearly 4 hours a day watching TV or online. That's more than 25 hours a week. Find just 5 or 10 hours, commit to using that time to grow your income, and I guarantee you it will make a major difference in your life. Your next millionaire habit is a commitment to always be learning and improving your skill set. When I asked Brian how long it took to feel like he really knew what he was doing investing, he said something I think any investor can relate to.
It took me a long time to feel like I halfway understood what I was doing. I don't think you really ever fully know what you're doing. I don't know that I'll ever know all there is to know about it. I highly doubt it, but I think I'll know enough to get us by.
There is a quote by Stephen Hawking, probably one of the smartest people that ever lived, that says, "Intelligence is the ability to adapt to change." Not book smarts or genius IQ. It is the ability to adapt to changes that creates greatness. And this applies to creating wealth, growing your business, whatever you're doing. Netflix started as a DVD rental service by mail after co-founder Reed Hastings owed $40 late fee at Blockbuster. Blockbuster has gone the way of the dodo, and rental competitor Redbox, not sure if that's still even a thing, but from a shift to streaming videos and then to creating its own content, Netflix has been able to grow into a $295 billion business because that founder Hastings and Randolph were constantly learning and adapting to their environment. When I got started blogging in 2015, I knew less than nothing about how an online business even worked. The first book I read was Blogging for Dummies, and that might have been a generous assessment of what I actually knew about it. Find something you enjoy doing. Use the action steps and the checklist that I'm going to give you next to get started. And make that commitment to always be learning how to grow your business. This next millionaire habit is more than just saying you have that no excuses mentality. It's a commitment to success, no matter what. This has to be more than just a slogan on a t-shirt. It has to be about setting those short-term goals and then doing what needs to be done to achieve them. And within each of those long-term goals we talked about earlier, you can make goals for the next year that are gonna help push you in that direction, but the real power in this is going to come from creating 12-week goals, something you can accomplish in the next 3 months that are going to move you a step closer to that one-year goal. Because of course, we all know what happens to those New Year's resolutions or the one-year goals you set. You want to lose 10 pounds in a year, or you want to make $1,000 a month from passive income. And what happens though, because you've got a whole year to reach those goals, you put off getting started. You end up waiting until December and then drop your goal because you'd have to cut off a foot to lose that 10 pounds in 2 weeks. But setting those near-term 12-week goals and then weekly tasks to accomplish those, that means you've got a sense of urgency to get things done. You're going to grow your business every 3 months and will accomplish something amazing by the end of the year. Those millionaire habits are just something we all have to work on, but now I want to show you 3 action steps you can use right now to map out how you'll become a millionaire. These are 3 rules you can use putting together your wealth creation plan that will guarantee you're on the right path. And first, with any passive income idea or business idea, ask yourself, how would you grow that income? Your business has to be scalable to make you rich. Now, what I mean by this is a lot of side hustles, a lot of business ideas start out making money, but you very quickly find out there's only so much that income can grow because you're trading your time for money. So with any kind of business or wealth creation plan, you need to be constantly thinking, how do I grow this income with less time? How do I serve more customers at the same time? Now, a great example of this is Brian and Crystal's lawn care business.
During our first year, we had so many customers, and we were having to turn people away. We knew that we had to reinvest in the business if we were going to be successful. You know, we couldn't keep going with a half-broke-down push mower and battery trimmers. Mm-hmm. We were going to have to put the first year a lot of our money back into the business. That way, the next year would be even better, and we could take on more customers, more yards, and actually be able to get some good hedge trimmers and be able to trim people's hedges in, you know, in a couple hours instead of 2 or 3 days.
This next millionaire rule is one of the most important. Instead of spending your money, reinvest it. Nation, I know it feels great to take those profits from your side hustle or from your investment returns and treat yourself, but that is not the way you create long-term wealth. That doesn't mean you can't have nice things, but real wealth creation means reinvesting that money back into the business for growth. And we see this in Brian and Crystal's story, reinvesting back into the business to buy those new mowers and the equipment. And yes, there is going to be that little voice in the back of your head nagging you just to spend the money, that the fear that investing in the business is just going to lose the money anyway. These are all natural fears, all voices that everyone confronts. Nation, I have not met a single millionaire business owner that hasn't at one point been so paralyzed by fear, they felt like just giving up and curling up into a fetal position. Have the confidence in your plan. Keep that commitment to reinvesting back into your business, and you will be on your way to real wealth creation. Now, finally here, before I reveal that 3-step checklist for getting started, never rely on just one source of income. Nation, there is no one solution for getting rich. The side hustles that we'll talk about in this series take time to build. The passive income ideas that I'll talk about in the next video won't create that $1 million income overnight. But put a few of these together and you can create a 5- and 6-figure income in no time. For example, starting my own blogs in 2015, it was 6 months before I made any money at all because I wasn't using a side hustle for that immediate cash flow. That's something that we'll fix for your plan in this series. That first income stream from self-publishing was a great motivator, but it wasn't going to pay the bills alone. I added affiliates and was able to make over $1,000 a month within that first year, but it still wasn't enough. I kept reinvesting in the business and looking for other ways to grow. Later, I added sponsor posts and was up to $2,000 a month and then averaging $4,000 and $5,000 a month within 2 years. When I finally started adding my own courses and YouTube, earning income from more than 6 sources, I was able to build that to over $60,000 and $70,000 a month. Over the next 2 videos in the series, I'll show you the very best side hustles and passive income ideas to start making money. I'll show you exactly how to get started in each and how much money you can make, but the real power in these is trying out a few, using a side hustle to start that immediate cash flow that you can reinvest back into your passive income idea or just to start investing. I know this is a lot to take in, so I want to give you that quick 3-step checklist to get you started on your path to $1 million. Now, you'll still need those habits and the action steps that we talked about before, but you can use these 3 quick steps to start creating wealth. And first, it's going to be to think about those goals and create your mental picture. This has to be where it starts, because without that mental picture of your dreams to motivate you, the challenges, the fears that come up along the way are going to destroy your progress. And remember, this is more than just thinking through those goals or saying you want some arbitrary amount of money, like $1 million. This means setting goals for that money and creating a story around it. Next is an easy one. Watch the 5-video series showing you exactly how to do all of this. Over the next 2 weeks, I'll be releasing the next 4 videos for a step-by-step into each part of creating wealth. We'll follow Brian and Crystal's journey through their side hustle, passive income strategy, and investing plan to show you how easy it is to set this up. I'll reveal more than 15 side hustles and passive income ideas to make sure you find the perfect one for your plan and give you a complete guide to start investing. And with that, you'll be ready for the last step, creating your own get-rich plan with income ideas and investing. You'll find a side hustle that will turn just a few hours a week into a quick source of cash and a passive income idea that you can build to start making money while you sleep. You'll be able to use that extra money to get a jump on your investing plan. Start making your money work for you. It's all right here, a complete plan to create wealth.
From beforehand, where I was scared to death, like, man, I don't know if we can do this. I don't know. But now I know that we can do this. And I know that we can probably do anything else that we decide to do.
It just takes off that weight off your shoulder. Yeah. You know, it's just a sense of relief.
Check out that link to the playlist with all 5 videos for creating wealth in the description below. And use Brian and Crystal's journey to inspire your own. Don't forget to join the Let's Talk Money community by tapping that subscribe button and clicking the bell notification.